Welcome back to the Upstate Warm-Up. My name is Scout Hoffmeyer here inside the Ingles Champion Suite inside the Hodge Center. Looking back at last week's competition, our softball team won 3 games, including a no-hit shutout over South Carolina State in the Wings Etc. Classic. Baseball continued their hot start with a road sweep over College of Charleston. Men's soccer picked up a home draw over 20th-ranked Campbell to keep an unbeaten Big South record. Women's golf had a strong start, showing at the Kiowa Island, picking up their first ever top 10 in the Kiowa Island Classic. For this week's student athlete interviews, we will be hanging out with softball's Mally Brown, Cassie Norris, and Marissa Sotorakis. Baseball's Sawyer Worrell, men's soccer, Orion McHugh. Lenny Mathis had a chance to catch up with head coach Rhonda Shirley to preview the series against High Point for this weekend.
We're excited to start a new promotion with our friends at the Beacon Drive-In. After every Upstate win this year, log on to our Upstate Spartans Instagram account. Show off that final score graphic at the Beacon Drive-In and score a free sweet tea. It's the sweet taste of victory from the Beacon Drive-In, where the food is always good since 1946. Support USC Upstate Athletics by joining the U Club. As a U Club member, you make a lasting impact on current and future generations of Spartans by providing for student athlete scholarships, facility upgrades, and championship experiences. Together, we can create transformative opportunities for our more than 250 student athletes to achieve academic and athletic success. Now is the time to join up and to make a difference. Log on to uscupstate.edu/joinup.
Welcome back to the Upstate Warm-Up. I had the opportunity to sit down with a softball trio that took over the Big South Awards this week. First off was sophomore Marissa Sotorakis, junior Mally Brown, and freshman Cassie Norris. Marissa came by with the Big South Conference Player of the Week, batted with a 444 over a 4-game span this weekend against ETSU and South Carolina State. Next up was Mally Brown taking Big South Conference Pitcher of the Week. Brown went 1-0 in 2 starts with this weekend with a 1.17. ERA. Cassie Norris took on Big South Conference Freshman of the Week. Norris started all 4 games with a DP and batted 375 with 3 hits, 5 runs, and 1 home run. Welcome back to the Upstate Warm-Up. My name is Scott Hoffmeyer, here with Marissa Sotorakis, a member of the Upstate women's softball team. Marissa, you batted a 444 over the span of this weekend, totaling 4 hits, 1 run, 1 double, and recorded a trio of RBIs. With this performance, you stand at Big South Player of the Week. Can you give insight to how you kept your momentum and consistency through the weekend?
Well, when I go up to bat, it all is just about, you know, having a good at bat. But what really keeps me going is when I go in the dugout and everyone's excited and we have just such good energy in the dugout.
Beautiful, girlfriend. Upstate softball is off to a hot start this season. What is a key component to your team's success?
We just work really hard always in practice, and we have so many girls pushing each other to be better every day. So I think that we're all just helping each other get better every day, and it's showing in the games.
Good. Beautiful. Well, Marissa, we are so happy to have you here at Upstate. Thank you so much for all you do.
Thank you.
I am here with Cassie Norris, another member of the women's softball team. Cassie, I hope after this weekend's home run, Upstate is starting to feel truly like home. Along with your numerous other honorable stats, your top accolade is Big South Freshman of the Week. Can you share a bit about what this means to carry this honor?
So I've been committed to Upstate since my junior year of high school, and I just remember looking up to those people before me getting these accolades, and I've always just wanted to be like them. And now that I'm like them, I'm hoping that like younger girls are looking up to me also and our team and watching us and getting behind us and supporting us.
Absolutely. Cassie, you have set the standard quite high to start off your freshman season. What are a few goals you are striving to achieve in your career as a Spartan?
I'm just hoping that this year we're able to be like the teams before us and win a Big South championship and do good in the postseason and just continue to have that family environment and work together as a team and just achieve all the goals we've already set.
Well, Ms. Norris, we are so happy that you're here with us at Upstate. Back to you guys. I'm here with softball player Mally Brown. Congratulations on throwing a no-hitter this weekend against South Carolina State. How has your preparation enabled you to post a standout performance like this past weekend?
Just in the bullpen working with Coach T, we do a lot on hitting our spots and locating the ball where we want it. So just doing that week to week has just prepared me every game day to hit my spots, and that's what I did.
So, Ms. Malley, you were named Big South Pitcher of the Week. What does this mean to you, and how will it motivate you for the rest of your season?
I think I set the standard pretty high for myself, and then my team having my back really just motivates me that they're going to have my back every single game from now on throughout the entire season. So I have high hopes for us moving forward.
Absolutely, absolutely. Can you name a few team goals that you feel sets Upstate softball apart from any other team in the Big South?
We focus on defense a lot, and that is one of our goals, is to have the best defense in the country. So priding ourselves in defense, backing up the pitchers, just sets us aside from everyone else, because we spend a whole lot of time on defense, taking reps, and that's like our main goal that we focus on here at Upstate.
Well, Miss Malley, we are so lucky to have you here. We thank you so much. Back to you guys at the Upstate Warm-Up.
After every Spartan victory, be sure and check out our social media feeds. And if the Spartans win, be sure to get the special promo code for 50% off your online order the day after any USC Upstate Hoops victory from Papa John's, proud supporter of your USC Upstate Spartans. Thanks to our friends at Vic Bailey Automotive for their support of USC Upstate Athletics. From new to pre-owned, on the lot or online, Vic Bailey has your next car. Shop right now, hundreds of vehicles online at...
I had the opportunity to sit down with Sawyer Worrell this week, the Big South Conference reliever of the week. Worrell fanned a career-high 8 batters and gave up 0 hits to preserve Upstate's 1-0 lead and earn his first collegiate save after pitching 4.1 innings against College of Charleston. Baseball returns to Harley Park this weekend for their Big South opening series against Radford. Welcome back to the Upstate Warm-Up. My name is Scout Hoffmeyer, and I am here with Sawyer Worrell from the men's baseball team. Sawyer, you had quite the season debut this Saturday. Your lefty pitch served well for the Spartans in 4.1 innings to help your team finish out the 1-0 win against the College of Charleston in Game 2 of the series. How did it feel to make such a statement upon the hill this past weekend?
Yeah, you know, we went out there, we had our game plan, we were focused on the job at hand, and, from there it was just... up to everyone. Defense played their part. Alex threw a great game to start it out, and defense made plays behind me, and we won the game.
And you were comfortable the whole way through?
Always.
Always, always. With your stellar performance, you collected Big South Relief Pitcher of the Week. Congratulations. With the bar set high for the rest of the season, what do you plan on doing or continue doing to capitalize on each opportunity you have up on the mound?
We have a great coaching staff, great team. As long as we just stay behind one another, everything will pan out how we need it to pan out.
It is a known fact that Upstate Baseball is one of 16 teams left unbeaten in the nation for Division I baseball. How has your team remained humble and hungry in order to keep that unaltered record?
We just go out there every day, stay hungry, don't get comfortable where we are. There's plenty of other teams that would like to be in the position we're in. And as long as we can stay hungry, continue to make pitches, make plays, hit the baseball, we'll be good.
Love that, love that. Well, Sawyer, we are so happy to have you here at Upstate. Thank you so much. Back to you guys at the Upstate Warm-Up.
It's in our hearts to feel for you. There's been ups and downs, turnarounds, good days and some bad. But we stand together for worse and for better. We'll always have your back, with open arms, heart to heart, hand in hand, community strong.
Where we find common ground, cheering together, unity. It's a foundation of founders and a staple of every team we support in our community. Things look different now. But when you get back to the court, back to the field, back to the diamond, we'll be right there too, with our support, just like always. Relax, you're with Founders.
Volleyball returns to the Hodge Center this week, Thursday and Friday, against the Big South favorite, High Point. Lenny Mathis had the opportunity to sit down with head coach Rhonda Shirley to preview this week's series.
Back in the Upstate Warm-Up, I'm joined by the head coach of our USC Upstate Spartans volleyball team, Rhonda Shirley. Coach Shirley, you are in the midst of, you've just come off of an opponent COVID pause. We're six matches into the year so far.
Talk to us a little bit about where you see your team at right now and what you're looking forward to the remainder of the spring season.
You know, teams just coming into the gym every day, just kind of grinding, working hard. You know, it's obviously for anybody, it's just difficult when you're on COVID pause and just kind of crossing your fingers every week that you're going to get an opportunity, you know, to play. But I'm really, you know, been proud of the progress that we've been making. Maybe hasn't been translating onto the win column every time. But I really feel like, you know, every day we're improving in the gym. They're really building a strong culture here. And, you know, I just think that they're definitely going in the right direction. And, you know, if we could just keep them, you know, seeing the light at the end of the tunnel, you know, every day. But they're doing a great job. They really are individually and as a team.
You know, it is a little discombobulating, though, even for those of us admins over here who, you know, you get ready for matches and you get prepared for them, and either, you know, luckily, knock on wood, if it's not yourself with any kind of issue, but your opponent has an issue and whatnot, mentally you feel like your team has been able to keep it together. And look, it was a really long fall, like practice the entire fall, too, to get to this point, so you know that they're still making that progress for you.
Yeah, and it is. It's been tough, I think, mentally. I think the plus for us, the couple COVID pauses that we had to do was coming from the other team and not us, you know. I think that's been a plus for us. But, yeah, I will say that, you know, just probably the most proud of them on how they've handled the whole COVID situation and just really trying to stay mentally engaged as much as we possibly can.
Some of the individuals that are standing out for you so far, Alexis Moreco is fifth in the league in blocks. Talk a little bit about what you've seen out of her so far this year.
She's a great kid. Just comes into the gym every day just with her head down, ready to work hard. She is a great force at the net defensively. We're trying to, you know, up her game a little bit from the offensive side. You know, the college she came from, you know, really training middles from more of a defensive end than an offensive end. And so we're trying to mirror those two. But yes, always does a very good job for us defensively at the net. And I just think that's going to continue throughout the season. And I think people are going to see her more active offensively too throughout the rest of the season and going into next year.
Scout Hoffmeyer, speaking on the defensive side, she's been a versatile player on that side for you, leading your team in digs and 10th in the league in that. And tell us a little bit about what you've seen with her.
Yeah, Scout's just a go-getter. You know, she's, you know, can put her in the libero jersey, can be a defensive, a DS for us. She's going to assume any role that we give her. You know, she jokes that, you know, we could put her in on the outside too, and she could swing for us. And I'm sure she would try to do it to the best of her ability. But, you know, Scout is, she's just a go-getter. She's going to take great pride in what she's doing. You know, defensively, she keeps us in a lot of games, keeps a lot of balls in play for us, and just kind of has that relentless pursuit, you know, mentality that helps us. And if we can really keep, you know, us in the game, I think a lot of times as the season goes on, we're going to be able to translate and transition a lot of those balls defensively out into play offensively to put points on the board. But, you know, Scout's just a great leader. She's just a great, you know, teammate, just a kid that you want on your roster. And so, you know, we have to have her out there in some capability. So she's just somebody I think people are going to see regularly on the court.
And not only do they see her on the court, they also see her in this show, because I'm pretty sure she's supposed to be the show, because I'm doing the interview today.
Right.
Certainly, she's great fun for us to work with, too. So, Kelly Wiedemann doing a nice job in aces for you. Brianna Strobert leading your team in kills. Some of the other members of your team making really good contributions this season so far.
Yeah, you know, and Kelly, yeah, she does a great job from the service line. I think that people are going to start seeing her, you know, produce a little bit more offensively. She's just a kid that really understands the game. You know, she's got a high IQ when it comes to the game, and she brings, I think, that maturity, you know, and so she's a stability for us for sure out there. And I just know at the net offensively, and I think from a blocking standpoint, she's going to start putting some more numbers on the board. And, you know, Bree Strobert, you know, she's somebody who saw very minimal time for us last year, but man, the way that this kid has progressed in just a year's time from freshman to sophomore, so excited to see how she continues to grow. She is a good threat for us at the net. She can put up a big block. you know, and obviously can put the ball away for us when we are needing it. And so she's somebody that we, you know, rely on for sure. And she's been doing a very good job of assuming that role, being someone who really didn't see the court a lot last year. So yeah, proud of that kid.
Primer for your next opponent is High Point. Both of those matches will be available on ESPN Plus. Give us a little bit of what you see out of the Panthers and what fans will be able to look forward to for this next back-to-back.
You know, High Point just has that tradition. They have a very solid team. You know, they're going to be a team that we're going to have to really stick with point for point. You know, they're going to bring a very solid team in here, a very talented team, you know, but also too that they're a team I think that we can compete with very well. But again, we're going to have to really win the serve and pass game with them. We're going to have to get them, you know, out of their offense. They've got some big swingers and, you know, try to contain them as much as we can. And that's going to start from the service line. So we're going to need that. And we're also going to need to have strong passing game on our side so we can run the offense as fluidly as we want to, using all of our weapons, you know, at the net. But again, for us, we're really just focusing on point for point and really being the stronger defensive team, you know, not just up at the net, but floor defensive wise, to keep us it not only in the game, but hopefully to frustrate also their attackers, you know, on the other side. So, but again, I mean, it's going to be another great challenge, you know, for us. We've really started off the conference with all the big dogs and the heavy hitters, but, you know, they're learning not to shy away from that challenge. And I think that that's, you know, showing great strides and just, I think, our maturity just throughout this short amount of time that we've been together. So it'll be a good match. I think it's going to be some great volleyball that people are going to see.
Well, good luck. And Brock Bowling will have the call along with Sarah Gildersleeve on ESPN Plus for High Point and Upstate Volleyball coming up. And Coach Shirley, appreciate your time and good luck.
All right. Thank you.
More of the Upstate warm-up right after this.
I remember when I was a little girl and maybe I had a tough day at school. I'd come home, go up the stairs to my room, and turn on some music on my boombox, because I knew that the music would make me feel a certain way. Music had a certain healing quality to it. And with the help of my life scholarship, I was able to major in music performance so that I could help bring that healing quality to others. I still think about it sometimes too, like, when I walk out on stage, or the moment the conductor lifts their baton and the room full of people fall silent, waiting to be inspired or comforted, seeking healing, and I get to help them find whatever it is that they're looking for. I get to be a part of that.
It is now time for the stat of the day from the South Carolina Education Lottery. From our men's soccer program, Felipe Beza leads the Big South Conference in saves per game, averaging 4.75 saves, and ranks 21st nationally with 19 saves on the season. I had the opportunity to sit down with Orion McHugh, who scored his first collegiate goal against number 20 Campbell on Sunday night. He also ranks second on the team for minutes played.
I'm here with Orion McHugh, a member of the men's soccer team. Orion, you had your first career goal as a Spartan in your matchup against nationally ranked the Campbell Camels on Sunday. Can you share a little bit of your emotion after that goal?
Yeah, that was a very special moment for me and obviously the team as well. I was just super excited, super happy to contribute in that way offensively. Usually I do more of the defensive stuff, but that was just very exciting for me, and to see the faces and the excitement everyone else had was just a great feeling.
Absolutely. Little does everyone know that you are practically a walking golden ticket, taking a redshirt your true freshman year, collecting a COVID year your sophomore year, and will be walking into your junior year as a true freshman on the field. How will you use these extra years of training to help you reach your own personal goals, as well as bring home the Big South trophy to the Upstate?
Yeah, I mean, obviously I have a lot of time on my hands to improve myself on the field and off the field. The off seasons are very big for me in terms of training back home and lifting weights and doing all that sorts of stuff and focusing on the finer details that just really make the difference. So, yeah.
You embody much of what it means to be a student athlete and have taken full advantage of the opportunities to not only better your peers, but your teammates as well. How has Upstate and the Spartanburg community impacted you?
Upstate has been just wonderful for me. My teammates, the friends I've made, the connections I've made, my coaches have been amazing. Obviously, they've been wonderful coaches and just great people and mentors in my life. And just the community of my team is great. Everyone's there to work hard, to work for each other, and just for a common goal of winning the conference championship. So.
Well, Ryan, we are so happy to have you here as a Spartan, and we thank you so much. Back to you at the Upstate Warm-Up.
And here we go for this week's lineup. Women's soccer versus Winthrop is Sunday, 6 p.m. on ESPN+. Volleyball versus High Point, Thursday, 6 p.m. and Friday, 4 p.m. on ESPN+. Baseball versus Radford, Friday, 4 p.m. Saturday, a doubleheader starting at 1 p.m. on ESPN+. Softball's on the road against Jacksonville in the Jacksonville UNF Spring Classic. The women's basketball Hercules Tires Big South Conference Tournament is on the road starting Saturday against Winthrop on ESPN3. Men's soccer is on the road at Winthrop Sunday night at 6 p.m. The women's golf team competes starting Sunday in the Winthrop Invitational, and our cross country competes Friday in the Big South Championships in Rock Hill. This has been Scout Hoffmeyer in the Ingalls Champion Suite. So long, and I will see you next week.